push him like you want to push him away. You push him like you want to punch him. But you don't use the fist, you use the hand. And you try to push him somewhere here on the upper body. So you take the breast or the shoulder. The higher, the better, okay? But not too high because you slip. So you need to practice just to find the right spot. In my opinion, it's right here, next to the chest. And the most important thing really is you throw it like a punch, and the moment you throw, you put the pressure on, your hand has to be straight, like a punch. When you throw the punch, you want to land in the moment where the hand is straight. Not like this, because here you don't have the power. It's the same with the takedown. You want to make sure your hand is straight, okay? So now, when I know this, I throw in this hand, my hand is stiff, and he will get pushed back, okay? And what happens, his upper body will be back, and his feet will be in front. So now, all I have to do is, I have to grab this foot here. I don't have to wrestle, I don't need any power. I just walk with him, bam, and he falls down, okay? So, one more time, I go. Okay, punches. And then on the third time, okay? Okay, you have to make sure to not get on the hand, because this can be a problem. You need to find the perfect spot to get on this. I like to go between the hands, like here. Okay? And from here you go. And you have it. Okay? Okay? George St. Pierre, he was very good on this takedown. Okay? Okay, George St. Pierre was really good on this takedown. And this takedown is really not about wrestling, because I'm not a wrestler. I'm a jiu-jitsu guy, okay? But you can take down everybody with it. Good wrestlers, good fighters, okay? It's a thing of timing. You need to have the right position for your arm. Straighten out, throw all the power in, and when you're here, you just grab it and you walk with him, okay?
I think it's a really nice gym. It's central Dublin, so the location is really good. The gym is nice, the people are really friendly. I'm very surprised because there are a lot of Polish people here. I almost feel like I'm in Poland. Everybody is super friendly, so I had a great time being here at the Phantom Gym. If they invite me here, I will come and teach a seminar and also train with their guys. I had a few grappling matches after the seminar, and they have some pretty strong guys, so it was also good training for me because I'm fighting in 3 weeks in Australia, so I need to work out. So it was good. It was good to teach a seminar and also train on my own.
I don't look every gym in Ireland, in Dublin, but this gym is good. It's a lot of Polish people and Ireland people. Yeah, it's okay.
The moment I feel I cannot defend the takedown anymore, I have to make a decision and make a special movement to make sure not to end up on my back, okay?
Tylko kiedy mnie wywrócił, od razu. Nasze łokieć, robimy taką łopatkę na jego kark, na jego głowę. Mostujemy z bioder i jego głowę przekładamy na drugą stronę. Bo jeśli jesteśmy w tym momencie, ciężko nam będzie wstać, tak? Ale jeśli jego głowę przeniosę, już mam dużo łatwiej do wstania, tak? Pyk.
The moment I arrived in Dublin, he was there bringing us food, supporting Krzysiek before his fight. It's amazing. I feel like it's like a family member, and it's not normal because they don't know me. They met me here for the first time. Everybody was so friendly. Amazing. I feel amazing. You know, I'm from Poland. I live in Germany, but I'm from Poland. I have a Polish heart, so for me, really, it feels like home. I like the Polish mentality. I like the vibrations in this gym. So of course, if I would be here, I would come to this gym to train.
No problem.
Guys, listen, we make one group photos on the end of this, so we can do this now before everybody go out. Okay? Come on, everyone. Remek.
Oh, we have actually many classes. From martial arts, we basic make on the most strongest. Our division is K1 Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu and MMA. That's the main idea for keep enrolling the club. Also, we do some separate classes, boxing classes like capoeira, Krav Maga. We do many classes for kids, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu for kids, some Zumba. Everything what we, you know, interesting the people, we try be elastic and, you know, keep full house every day. You know, like it's on the martial arts club, no, for 100% people what will be come to the club, maybe 3-4 guys will be real fighters in the future, but we care about everybody, you know, we really care about the show the people, no have to be straight away the fighters, but if he make him, you know, adventurous with any martial arts in his life with our club, and just remember that that's something good for him, you know, he can make him a little bit help in the life or anything, but we get every level of the of the skill. We make great great cooperation with special students. We do the great job with DIT. We do that second year. It's packed. DIT students come just and take our experience from 8-10 weeks courses with us, and yeah, that make us very fun. Yeah.
Okay, party people in the house. You're about to witness something you've never witnessed before. So listen close, so you all don't miss. As we go a little something like this. Hit it! There is no competition. We are the best, yeah. There is no competition.